Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.4 is finally making iOS 15 feature complete. What I mean by that is Apple announced iOS 15 back in June of 2021, and then they released it in September. Since then, we haven't had all of the features they initially showed. Now with iOS 15.4, we do. We have Apple Digital ID starting up in Arizona and will be in other states soon and hopefully other countries as well. We also have things such as Apple Car Key and then Universal Control. So all of the initial features that were promised are now here with iOS 15. So that of course means we're going to get new features later on with later versions. So I wanted to talk about that and also battery life, since some people are saying battery life isn't great. There's been articles about it in 15.4, and then Apple even said wait 48 hours and see what it's like, or even longer. And I wanted to share battery life, not just my battery life, but thousands of others, to see if it actually is worse or if it's the same or better. So the first thing is battery life. And of course, we'll read comments in a moment. I'll take a look at some of the things you had to say, and of course, stability and statistics as well. This is a little bit different than the traditional follow-up. Now, the first thing is battery life. This is my iPhone 13 Pro Max in green, and I used this for a little while on 15.4, and I'm also testing another phone right now. I'll show you in a moment. But you can see as I was running 15.4, on this day, I had 4 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 33 minutes of screen off time, and used about 45% of my battery. So that means on this day, I'd get about 9 to 10 hours of screen on time with 6 to 7 hours of screen off time. So it just varied from day to day, but typically it was getting me through a day and a half without a problem, no issues there, and it's been reliable that way. However, on my iPhone SE, which I've been using full time for the past few days so I can do a full review on it, I wanted to make sure I knew what it was like to use. So we'll go into the settings, go to battery, wait for it to load, and over the past few days, you'll see this wasn't that great. 2 hours and 41 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 14 minutes of screen off time, and this phone is set up exactly like the 13 Pro Max that I'm using. So they have the exact same configuration, everything else. And so about 3 hours of screen on time used almost 100% of my battery. The day before, it was sort of newer, but 3 hours and 44 minutes of screen on time. So I did have to plug it in before the end of the day. Today, so far, 1 hour and 2 minutes at about 25%. So about 4 hours of screen on time is what I'm seeing with this. Some people may see more. But so far for me, that's what I'm getting with this particular update. So on iOS 15.4, I've never used the iPhone SE before. That's what it came pre-installed with. And so this SE third gen is getting me almost through a day. So I'll talk more about that in its final review. But battery life is actually much better than most people think. Now, like I do every week, I ran a YouTube community poll, and just an hour ago, I ran this poll to see what battery life was like. Now, prior to this, I used the poll from before with over 700 comments in it, and then took all of that information, compiled it to see what people said about battery. And 62% say battery is the same or better than earlier iOS 15 updates, with only 38% saying that battery is bad. However, if we take a look at the other poll that I ran today, you'll see out of 4,100 votes or so, maybe even more than that, 50% say that it's the same or better than iOS 15.3.1, 34% say battery life is great, and only 15% or 16% rather say that it's poor or terrible. So battery life is much better than I think some people are making this out to be, and I think that's great news. So out of over 4,000, about 4,500 people, if you include the YouTube community poll before, have said that it's actually the same or better. So that's good news. Most people don't experience problems, and if you do, give it a few more days. If not, there have been some odd issues here and there, such as crashes, stability issues, and more. However, most people don't seem to experience that either. So a good example is I went through the YouTube community poll to see what people had to say. And in that community poll, 15 people said that they had crashes, only 5 people saw freezes, and only 1 person out of 700 comments had it actually respring or completely lock up and reboot. So this is actually good news. That means that we're not seeing a ton of issues overall, but that doesn't mean there aren't still issues. Cellular connectivity remains to be an issue, especially on the 13 Pro Max for me. In fact, on the iPhone SE, it seems to be a little bit better. It doesn't have a millimeter wave antenna, but it does have sub-6, and typically it's quite good for me. You'll see I'm using the hotspot now. I'm actually relaying the internet over to the 13 Pro Max, and in general, the overall connection's quite good. I really have not had a problem with the SE when it comes to connectivity, but some people have issues where there's temporary drops. Wi-Fi seems to still be fine. Bluetooth is working well for most. Occasionally there's some issues, but there are about 2 to 3 issues that still remain to be resolved or need to be resolved. And that has to do with the music bug. So the music bug is if you're streaming music, so maybe you're streaming a song, you're streaming some sort of song here before downloading it, what it will do is cause the CPU to actually use more power than you would expect, and then of course drain the battery because you're using a ton of CPU power. Also, we have issues with CarPlay, and this seems to be across the board depending on the car that you have. I've mentioned before where it was Honda and Acura, being that they're the same company, but then again, we don't really know what's going on, as some people with BMWs and Mercedes have issues as well. So it seems to be across the board, Apple changed something that causes it to have a few issues here and there. So there's definitely some things they need to fix. And of course, that leads me to, where is iOS 15.5? This past week, we expected there to be a beta, and there just wasn't. This is the first time in many years, probably, we haven't seen a beta after a public release, at least a week out or so. And I think the screen protector is making the screen look like that, but maybe not because of the iPhone recording this video. You'll see it moving, that could be the PWM. But as you see here, on the 26th today, when I'm recording this, I would expect an update probably on Monday or Tuesday or even Wednesday, but now we're in uncharted territory and we just don't know. So I think this week, maybe on Wednesday, we'll get invites to WWDC. Let me switch over to this phone. While an LCD cannot go as bright, of course you won't see the PWM, so you won't see that line moving. That's sort of the frame rate syncing up with the actual shutter speed and things like that. So as you can see here, it's the 26th when recording this video. I would expect an update early in the week, but WWDC invites probably Wednesday based on what they did last year. Last year, Apple sent them out on the 30th, and then we had WWDC in June, and that's where we can expect to see the majority of the big changes with iOS 16, macOS 13, watchOS 9, and of course, tvOS and HomePod OS changes as well. So all of those things are expected in June, usually around the 6th or 7th. But for now, I think iOS 15.5, if it's not out this coming week, Apple's changed everything completely, and maybe we won't see as many iOS 15 versions as we have in the past. But right now, we're kind of in an area we haven't seen before. Apple's changing it up. Maybe they're going for more reliability and stability as well. Now, it's actually quite windy outside, so hopefully you can hear me okay, but let's take a look at what you had to say. Travis Myers said, iOS 15.4 running on my iPhone 12 Pro Max seems to be the worst release so far. It's been very buggy, battery life has been awful, and I've run into a lot of situations where my screen would just freeze. I'm hoping for the next beta very soon. And like I said, thankfully most people are not having an issue with it actually freezing up. Maybe try a hard reboot, or you could do a full reinstall, but I have seen a few issues where people had their phones reboot and had to actually restore using iTunes to get this to work properly again. It seems to be pretty rare, but definitely something that's happening. Alejandro Perez says, improved my 13 Pro Max cellular connection, used to drop randomly so often, still happens at times, but rarely. Not sure if it's a T-Mobile issue or an Apple issue, but I'm just glad it's improved with 15.4. Like I said, it depends on the phone for me. It definitely seems better than before, but they still have some work to do on it. Hamza Syed said, there is no visual changes, but as the update said, it is for Face ID unlocking when face mask is on, so sometimes it behaves abnormally even when you don't have a mask on. The good thing, though, is enhanced battery timing. At a full day of heavy usage on the 12 Pro Max, I would get 7.5 screen on time with battery percentage at 15% to 20% and slightly heated up. But now the screen on time has increased to 8.3 hours with battery percentages between 20 and 25%. So definitely an improvement there. Gabriel Moses Lee Production says, iOS 15.4 is great for me on my iPhone 13 Pro Max. Performance is great, battery life is great, and ProMotion is great too, and the storage bug is finally fixed on my 13 Pro Max. Battery is insane. Just got a 13 Pro Max yesterday, and on iOS 15.4, I'm losing only 5% per hour. I can't even believe that battery is so good on this phone. And someone just started mowing over there, so hopefully it's not too distracting. Roman Lindley says, iOS 15.4 has been amazing, but today at work had a massive battery drain from 100% to 9%. I'd not even used the iPhone 13 Pro Max at all, so unsure what had happened. Charging overnight again to see what happens tomorrow. And at least the first couple of days, there's some odd things going on. Apple could be doing something in the background. In fact, they actually did do a test in the background years ago when they came out with APFS and sort of tested out some things. So there could be some odd things going on. They haven't said officially, but it seems like there's some odd issues here and there. Diablo GT says, sadly for me, the lag and stutter issue is still present on my 13 Pro Max on 15.4. I don't know what to do. Some apps like Twitter and Reddit are awful. Turning off autoplay makes it better, but not perfect. Basically, every app has this problem, some more than others. The only thing that got better is scrolling through PDFs in Safari. And that has to do with ProMotion being a little bit better in Safari. So this time around, ProMotion should work better for third-party developers. They can enable it, and it should be smoother overall. Boko no Sakai says, ever since I updated to 15.4 on an iPhone SE 2016, the battery performance has been terrible with battery health at 91%. Just idle overnight, already consumed roughly 20%. That's why I typically recommend you plug it in so it can do all of those background processes, Wi-Fi and more, and let it manage its battery itself. Typically takes care of those issues. But if you don't have that option, of course, it shouldn't be draining that much either. Graham Evans says, absolutely recommend this update. No faults or bugs on my iPhone 13. Face ID with a mask on works great, and battery life is awesome. No complaints here. Best iOS 15 upgrade to date. JH says, I'm on iOS 15.4 on my 13 Pro Max, and it's been excellent for me. No issues or bugs as far as I'm aware. Performance is amazing. I don't have connectivity issues, and the battery life is great. Still at 100% battery health too. I don't have CarPlay and I don't use Apple Music, so I can't speak to those issues. I never had the pink display bug, but the storage bug is fixed for me. Cellular switching from LTE to 5G, 5G ultra wideband on Verizon has been better with time too. No complaints here, solid iOS release. Jesse Batista said, I'm pretty satisfied. The update even fixed this weird bug with my AirPods that would cause them to disconnect and then call them not yours. So I'm a happy camper right now. I do recall seeing that in previous versions, so it's definitely fixed in this one and much better. And so that's everything with iOS 15.4. Thankfully, most of these things have been resolved. Of course, I do expect maybe Apple to push out an iOS 15.4.1 if they're not going to do a 15.5, maybe to fix those initial issues and hopefully that music bug eventually. So hopefully we'll see that very soon along with 15.5 betas and that WWDC invite. Let me know if there's any other issues I haven't mentioned that you haven't seen elsewhere in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.